In this video, we'll show you two surface materials that are configured in a way that brings out the best of both, the image library files used in them, and the CineRender engine. Also, we will compare the results and differences between the standard and the physical renderer. Before starting to create your own surface materials with ArchiCAD, let's stop for a minute and talk a little bit about the importance of test scenes. Surface materials behave in various ways when light conditions change. You will most likely present your buildings in different light conditions. Therefore, it's important to have a fixed scene that your eyes get used to, so you can compare similar materials under the same lighting conditions, and judge on your own if surface material is properly configured compared to previously made materials. Also, this helps you compare the newly created materials with the images from your memory that you've been collecting subconsciously by walking on the street or visiting construction sites. Let's say you use one or two fixed scenes each time you configure the same type of surface material. For instance, concrete in this example. It matches your taste as well as the real look of that particular material, but when you use that material under different light conditions, it doesn't look as expected in the rendered image. Most likely it's not your material that you have a problem with, but more likely you have a problem with the lighting of your scene, or perhaps the camera settings, or with the render settings. A fixed scene not only means to observe and render surfaces from the same camera angle and have the same sun position and lamp settings, but also to use the very same camera exposure and render settings. For different materials, we need proper scenes offering specific light conditions. Here, for example, we have a concrete surface and exterior light. The sun is in the descending phase. If we test a properly configured wood floor material on this wall, it will look far from being perfect. However, if we render this same wood floor material in an interior scene where we have an additional light source behind the window, an area light, the true nature of our wood flooring material will be revealed, and it'll turn out that there's nothing wrong with how our wood material has been set up. Let's take a look at our scene and how it's been set up. As a light source, we have a sun with an altitude at 50 degrees. Behind the wall, we have a morph object that we're using as a light source. It has a special surface material with the following properties: luminescence at 100, under illumination, the GI strength is set to 2000. By the way, the default value here is 100. The GI value defines how much a material contributes to the global illumination in our scene. Although this morph is not a lamp object, thanks to its surface material, it will emit light. Parallel to the wall, we have another morph object that serves as a reflex object to simulate reflected light that would otherwise come from a surrounding building. The surface material of the reflex object has the color channel set to 75%. The color value is RGB, 255 each. Both these morph objects help compensate for the missing surrounding buildings and the light that would otherwise be reflected from them. Finally, the floor surface material is a neutral gray with RGB values of 127 each. All these objects and the surface material settings make it possible to show how our concrete material behaves when exposed to direct sunlight, when it's shaded and receives light from only the sky and reflected light from nearby surfaces, when it's in hidden areas, receiving almost no light at all, and finally, when it's exposed to grazing light. Now let's take a look at the render settings. We have no lamps, so it's turned off. We have no sun object placed, and sun is turned on in environment. Therefore, the physical sky will provide the sun, and only the sun position set in the camera settings will be used. All other sun parameters can be controlled under physical sky, sun. We have an illuminating surface in the back of our scene, so this is turned on. Sun and sky is provided by the environment's physical sky option, as mentioned earlier. To include the light that the sky provides to our scene, we have global illumination turned on. GI mode is irradiance map. We are rendering a still image. Also, we are outdoors without any sensitive small details, so QMC is not needed now. Using IR only will also help to keep our render time low. QMC refers to quasi Monte Carlo mode. Please read the help section for further information. Don't be afraid to use a diffuse depth higher than 3. The shadows will be nicer. If you use the following settings, the diffuse depth will not slow down your render time. The method option under stochastic samples is set to custom accuracy at 75%. We leave everything else unchecked here. Under irradiance cache, the interpolation is weighted average, and everything else we keep on low values. Detail enhancement is turned off because it will not make our render nicer in this particular example, but rather would greatly slow down the render time. When working with CineRender, you have two options to choose from. Physical render turned on. This also enables us to use a physical camera. Or physical render is turned off. Although it's not labeled anywhere, when physical render is turned off, the so-called standard renderer takes its place. Both renderers can offer similar results. However, to achieve a more realistic look and feel, the physical renderer with appropriate physical camera settings is the way to go. Let's compare the results each engine can offer. When we use the standard renderer, physical is off. The anti-aliasing quality of our render image is controlled by the setting under Options, Anti-Aliasing. For a crisp, clear result, we'll use the Best preset. Now let's render our scene again with physical renderer. Please note anti-aliasing under Options is grayed out because in physical renderer, the anti-aliasing is controlled by the sampling quality parameters. To achieve the same crisp, clear result, we use the following values. Sampling subdivision at 6, shading minimum at 4, shading maximum at 7, and shading error threshold at 16. Please note that this video clip you are watching is re-encoded 2 times before it reaches your screen, so some quality loss is inevitable, and the following differences may not be obvious or visible. Please test the described settings with your own project using similar conditions to see the difference. The differences between the two renders are the following. With the provided settings, physical renderer is almost 2 times faster in the case of this particular scene, and the quality is almost identical. When the standard renderer is used, the image on the left side, the result is too sharp in regions where we expect it to be a little bit blurry, for example in this area where the concrete is exposed to light and it's closest to the camera. It's quite normal to see this area as crisp, clear, and sharp. But where the concrete receives no direct sunlight at all, our eyes expect the surface to be blurrier, especially in this corner. At the same time, the render made by the physical renderer is exactly what we want. The surface exposed to light is crisp, clear, and sharp. Shaded regions from the camera are blurry. Please note we are not using the depth of field effect at the moment, although this is otherwise available if needed. Look at the top of the wall. This highlight here in the edge is a bit unrealistic and too strong. In physical renderer, it looks fine, smooth, and mild. At the same time, here where the concrete gets direct sunlight, both results are fine. Finally, the shadow. In standard renderer, shaded areas appear darker, and the surface material is also darker. For example, here and here. This is both the result of unbalanced sharpness and clamped shadow. In our image made with physical renderer, all these areas have nice balanced shadows. As our concrete is gray, the difference in the quality of the shadow is not so obvious. But in this other scene, where we'll set up wood floor materials, the difference is more dramatic. Again, the left image is rendered with standard renderer, and the right with Physical Renderer. Please take a look at this corner, for example. Also here. And here. Certainly, both renders offer great results. However, the listed differences do change the final look and feel of your renderings. It's yours to decide whether you want a harsh or more realistic result. As we are satisfied with the speed and quality of our render settings, we will store them. Please note the purpose of this video is exclusively to focus on the importance of test scenes when setting up your surface materials. For a more detailed explanation of the render settings window and the fine-tuning of render parameters, please watch the following video clips dedicated exclusively to this subject. In conclusion, please make sure to set up your custom-made surface materials considering these facts, and always use a scene that reveals the true nature of your materials.